Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll look at patent assignee searching. That is, when you go into one or more of the patent databases on Dialog to identify all of the patents or published patent applications owned by a company or person. Usually you're searching on a company name. There are at least two ways to do this on Dialog, and I'll demonstrate both of them for you. And at the end, since we'll be using the INPADOC database, I'll offer some tips on your download options for patent families found in INPADOC. So let's get started. Now in this example, we've been doing some searching in the 31 full-text patent databases looking for patents about personal protection equipment, or PPE, things like breathing masks. And we found this interesting patent. It's from Australia, was issued in 2015. This mask has a pleated surface for a better fit on a person's face. So that's interesting. And it was made by a company called Moldex Metric. So if we want to find out what else this company has patented, there are a few things we can do. We can simply click on it. Notice, by the way, there are other things that are underlined and in blue here. We can click on any of these things, like this international classification code or this application number, anything we see highlighted like that, and Dialog will automatically run a search for that value. In the case of the patent assignee, therefore, we can simply just click here, and we will get a search across all of these 31 databases, and we get 154 hits for Moldex Metric, Inc. Now, we might get a few more hits if we went instead into INPADOC because it has broader country coverage. But the more important limitation here that I want to point out is that by clicking on the assignee name, Dialog has run this as an exact search. You see the field is PA.exact and that the company name is in quotes. So we're getting 154 results, but those are only the ones where the patent assignee name is in the record as exactly Moldex Metric, Inc. If there's any variation on that, then this search will not bring it up. So this is a good search. It's certainly fast and easy, but I'd like to show you the better and more complete way to find all of the patents by Moldex Metric. And this time, the first thing I want to do differently is to go instead into the INPADOC database, because as I mentioned, INPADOC has the broadest country coverage, which makes it a good choice for a patent assignee search. I'll go into INPADOC, and I'm going to go into Advanced Search. I go to this first row, and I change this drop-down box from the default to Patent Assignee, PA. When I do that, I get a link that appears here, says Look Up Patent Assignees, and when I click on it, this opens a special tool for this purpose called Look Up Patent Assignees. Now, in this box, I'm going to leave this button at contains, and I'm going to type Moldex. The hyphen isn't important. I'll just put Moldex Metric. In fact, I'm just going to put the first part of it. Sometimes that's a good precaution in case the rest of the word is misspelled in the patent. And we see here a number of variations on that company name. There is Moldex Metric, but we also see Moldex Metric AG & Co. KG, which has a significant number of patents. Down here we see Moldex Metrics with an X. Is that the same company that's been misspelled? Well, it's hard to be sure, but I'm going to go ahead and include that as well. This is something that we would have missed because of the misspelling in the record itself if we had not used this lookup tool. So the next thing I do is to click Add to Search down here. And you see Dialog has filled in all of our selections in this box. And this is a good search for everything where Moldex Metric, with all of its variant names, was the original patent assignee. But that is only part of the search, because sometimes the patent may have been assigned initially to someone else, perhaps another company that sold it to Moldex Metric. But often the patent first comes out in the name of the inventors, so that the company name is the reassignee, which is the pair field, P-A-R-E, but they're not the P-A. So what we want to do is in this second row is set this drop down to pair, patent assignee reassigned. This again brings up a new link that says look up new assignees, and we get a similar tool that says look up new assignees. So again, in here, I will type Moldex metric. I'll just put met, click find, and we see a couple of additional ones here. Notice that part of the address or location turns up. That's quite often the case in the new assignee search. So I'll select those, and now they appear down here. The next thing we want to do, and this is very important, is to change this connector from AND to OR, because what we want is a combination of all of the patents owned initially by this company or that were reassigned to them afterward. And now we're ready to click search, and we have our total number of hits, which now is 221, significantly more than 154 that we got just by clicking on the name and getting the records where the exact name was Moldex Metric Inc. Now, since we're in INPADOC, I want to show you one more thing here. We have 221 results because that's how many individual patents are assigned to this company. But if we want to, we can instead reduce the number of hits to only one hit per family. We do that over here. You see, we're now looking at the results from show all results. That would be a separate record for each family member, each publication. But if we want to, we can reduce this to only one record for each patent family. We can choose either the earliest or basic patent of the family, or we might want to see the most recent one. I'm going to pick earliest and then click update. And now we have significantly fewer. We have only 95 results. Note that if we wanted to know all of the patent numbers, we would have to download these results in a format that includes the patent family. So when doing download all results, we might choose this and be sure to check off include family information. Or instead, we could choose as our format something like the family table or family member details. And that too would get us all of the patent numbers across only 95 records instead of over 200. But either way we choose to do it, we have gotten all 221 patent numbers available to us by doing the patent assignee search using the lookup tools. So that's it. We've seen how you can click on an assignee name in any patent record to get one-click results on all patents assigned to that exact name. And we saw how you can look for additional records where a company's name might appear in variant forms, or where the company is a reassignee to the patent, by using the Lookup Patent Assignee and Lookup New Assignee tools in Advanced Search. If you'd like more information, here are some links to additional resources, or if you have questions or you need help, feel free to call the help desk at these numbers, or you can email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.